Was China and the World Health Organization too slow to respond to the COVID-19 pandemic? Is the reason that the entire world still suffering with COVID-19 ultimately China's responsibility? These are some important questions, and I'd like to answer them, breaking it down with some facts, videos, and logic. Let's get started. Hi everyone, my name is Cyrus Jansen. I'm an American expat that has lived around the world for the past 14 years, 10 of those being in Greater China. And if you're new to this channel, we make weekly vlogs about China and its role in society today. Many people around the world have been continuously blaming China. For example, the hashtag China lied, people died has been trending for well over 8 months on Twitter, and it still remains a fact that many people do blame China for the COVID-19 pandemic. However, there was a recent event that really set a lot of people off in the West, and that happened on December 31st, 2020, in the city of Wuhan. As Western media companies like CBS started to share footage of Wuhan and the tens of thousands of residents that poured into the street to celebrate the new year by releasing thousands of balloons into the sky, many Westerners around the world were very angry. They could not believe the audacity of these Chinese people to go into the streets and to celebrate the new year, especially when cities like New York City's Times Square had to shut down for New Year's Eve. This was absolutely unfair, and a lot of people took to Twitter to share their frustration. Hang on, the Chinese have a different New Year than the West. Is this real footage? Can't be real. Must have been from a previous year. Something tells me these people were forced to be there and there will be large COVID numbers. And China will hide it. How is this possible when the rest of the world is indoors? Now, this last tweet is actually a legitimate question. You see, when COVID-19 impacted China, people took it serious. They listened to the government, and all Chinese people did what they had to do. They went into a strict lockdown. Well, the best footage that I've found comes from a documentary called Blaming Wuhan. I'm going to show you a 2-minute clip that gives you some phenomenal insights into the city of Wuhan and what its citizens really went through for 76 days. Let's watch it now.
January 23rd, 2020. If you've never heard of the city Wuhan before, you certainly have now. Wuhan, a city of 11 million people, the size of London, is the capital city of the central China's Hubei province. Chinese authorities have confirmed a city-wide lockdown to combat a new deadly virus labeled COVID-19. Wuhan went into a then unprecedented lockdown on the 23rd of January, at a time where the virus had killed 17 people and affected more than 400. A city larger than New York is fighting for its life. A new rapidly spreading dangerous disease, killer virus, has hit the streets of Wuhan. Only now we know how vicious and infectious this mutating virus actually is. This was the start of the worst pandemic in a century. The human costs extracted by the world's largest known quarantine in China may never be known. The people of Wuhan sent a warning shot to the entire global civilization that COVID-19 was a virus to be feared. China had confirmed 90,000 cases of COVID-19 and 4,739 deaths, while the United States has registered 100 times more, 9 million cases of the COVID-19 and a staggering 229,000 deaths to date. All of which raises the question, how has China managed to wrest control of its pandemic? With a countrywide implementation of a contact tracing app, a centralized epidemic response system, 14,000 health checkpoints were established and public transport was suspended. On the 5th of February 2020, Wuhan had opened its emergency hospitals. Track and trace systems to identify and isolate people who might be spreading the illness. Rigorous and speedy countermeasures were a crucial factor in containing the virus.
Now, looking at this video footage, it's very obvious to see that China's version of a lockdown is very different than what we have experienced here in the West. I'm going to give you an example. On December 31st, 2020, here in Vancouver, Canada, where I am currently based, this is what was floating around on the streets of downtown Vancouver. A flyer advertising a New Year's Eve Freedom Rally party. Look at what's included. Inspiring guest speakers, live DJ. There's even a kids' corner with hot chocolate. Wow, let's protest the government and make this a family affair. What a great idea to do during the middle of a global pandemic. I mean, look at the caption on the bottom of the flyer. We are protesting the government's orders and we will celebrate. I mean, the difference between Western society and China and other countries in Asia is just shocking. But let's get into the meat of this video. Where did the COVID-19 virus actually originate from? Is it really from the city of Wuhan? Well, let's listen to top doctor from the World Health Organization, Dr. Michael Ryan.
With regard to the Wuhan seafood market, in fact, one of the interesting findings is while there was most certainly a temporal and geographic cluster associated with the market, not all of the cases in that initial cluster can be linked directly to the market. So the market is likely to have been a point of amplification.
So the important takeaway from here is that the market in Wuhan was actually a point of amplification. It is not where the first case came from. So where do we go to find that first case? Well, let's continue listening.
So this case zero that you mentioned may not be, in fact, case zero. There could have been other cases that existed that weren't detected because they weren't picked up through a current surveillance system. That's not a criticism. That's just a possible fact that we need to look back. We need to look retrospectively to see what happened.
So it's becoming quite clear that case zero was, in fact, again, not in the city of Wuhan. And in fact, it probably was going around undetected for a long time. She also said that we need to go back and start looking at other cases. Well, I found an interesting video from American media that surfaced in July 2019. That's right, July 2019, a full 7 months before the breakout in Wuhan. Let's have a look at this video.
The deadly outbreak in a retirement community. At least two patients have died, dozens more sickened, and tonight parts of that facility are now under quarantine. ABC's Kira Phillips is on the scene.
Tonight, a deadly outbreak in Virginia. Two deaths and dozens of residents sickened by a respiratory illness here at the Green Spring Retirement Community.
For a respiratory outbreak to occur in July would certainly not be as likely as for it to occur during the winter.
In just the past 11 days, 54 people have become ill, symptoms ranging from a bad cough to pneumonia. No promising leads on how the sudden illness broke out. But in a statement from the retirement facility, it says it has taken all necessary measures to fully implement proven infection prevention and control strategies.
David, health officials are testing patient swabs, hoping to figure out what this virus or bacteria is. Meanwhile, sick residents have been quarantined to their rooms. New residents are not being admitted, and all staff are wearing masks and protective gloves until test results bring about answers.
Now, I'm not implying that this case in the nursing home was in fact COVID-19. However, when you look at the symptoms and how the doctors were treating the situation, especially with this pneumonia and this flu-like symptom going around in midsummer, it does seem very strange. And a lot of the symptoms does seem very similar to COVID-19. It's certainly a point that needs further investigation. But the big takeaway from this is that we now almost have come to a realization that COVID-19 most definitely did not originate in China. It was simply discovered in China. Let's take a look at some other Western media sources that are confirming this. Here's the global news in Canada. Coronavirus traces found in Spanish sewage sample from March 2019. Forbes.com. Coronavirus may have hit Los Angeles in December before the Wuhan outbreak. Here's CNBC. Coronavirus emerged in Italy earlier than thought. The Guardian? Could COVID-19 have reached the UK earlier than thought? And let's go down under to see the Australian. Italy had COVID-19 in September last year. Now again, this is very important. This is Western mainstream media sources that are all basically saying the same thing. COVID-19 was circulating around the world well before anybody actually even knew of the city of Wuhan. But some of you might be thinking, Cyrus, I get it. Okay, fine. It did not originate in China, and simply the Wuhan sea market was just a point of amplification. But the reality is, what about all of the international flights that left the city of Wuhan after the lockdown? That is ultimately what spread this virus around the world. So it's still China's fault. Well, that's a theory, but it has actually been already disproven. Let's take a look at this article from factcheck.org. This article is entitled Trump's Flawed China Travel Conspiracy. And in this, Donald Trump says you could fly out of Wuhan, where the primary problem was, and you could go to different parts of the world. But you couldn't go from Wuhan to Beijing, and you couldn't go to any other place in China. So what's that all about? But that's wrong. Flight records show that China did block international commercial flights out of Wuhan after January 23rd, according to Flight Radar 24, a global flight tracking service. Now at this point in the video, I'd like all of us to go back in time 12 months. Let's go back to China 12 months ago and put yourself in the situation of Chinese officials, Chinese authorities, and the citizens of the city of Wuhan. 12 months ago, there was a mysterious virus that emerged in the city of Wuhan. Nobody at the time knew anything about this virus, and the Chinese government was forced to make a very bold decision at the time. They decided to lock down the entire city of Wuhan, and then subsequently lock down the entire country of China. At the time, this was a very bold decision. Essentially, this had never been done in modern history. You see, many people are quick to judge China now. If China would have just locked down earlier, we wouldn't have been in this mess. But again, go back in time. 12 months ago, the concept of locking down a city, going into quarantine, wearing face masks, social distancing, all of these concepts did not exist in our worlds 12 months ago. All of us have just been desensitized because the entire world has now had to do this over the last year. But again, let's not forget that China was the first mover. They were the first country that was severely affected by COVID-19. Now let me give you an analogy to better understand the situation. Let's imagine that you wanted to climb Mount Everest. Your path to the top of Mount Everest today is much easier than the first person who climbed Mount Everest. Because as the first mover, that path to the top is unknown. You are a trailblazer. You are making a difference. And this is what is happening with China. China was the first country into COVID-19. They adapted, they learned, and that is why they were the first country out of the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, did China make mistakes in the beginning? They did. And they actually admitted it themselves. The reality is that if you are the first mover, you inevitably will make mistakes because you do not have all of the information. And it makes me wonder, when I see articles like this from CNN, China could have acted quicker and more forcefully to contain the start of COVID-19 outbreak. Then what can we say about America? America, for example, was not the first mover. They had ample notification from China and from other countries in the world that COVID-19 was coming. But our president decided to deny the existence of COVID. He said it was nothing but a common flu. And in fact, he did not prepare America or its citizens or the hospitals to handle the upcoming pandemic. How about this image? Wanted, one thing the USA did faster than China with COVID-19. Just one single thing. Now, I know this image is meant to be a joke, but it's also serious. Seriously, go out and try to name one thing that the United States did better than China in response to COVID-19. I mean, we did not learn from China. We did not learn from anybody else. And we simply denied the fact that COVID-19 exists. We still have people out there in America that deny COVID-19. Only in Western countries could something as simple as a face mask be considered a political statement instead of something that could ultimately save your life. But for some people, they still want to blame China. For example, one of the common questions that I've seen is, why did it take China so long to share the genetic code of the COVID-19 virus? Well, that's a great question. Why don't we ask one of the top Chinese virologists? Now, in this article from sciencemag.org, the house was on fire, top Chinese virologist on how China and the US have met the pandemic. Top virologist Xiao Yiming, who works for China's Center for Disease Control and Prevention, directly answers this question. When you share that with the world, you need to confirm it is accurate. They had to sequence several samples to make sure. A single scientist's findings cannot be used. Usually in China, as is common practice around the world, for all new pathogens, we have to ask two additional institutes to repeat the results and verify them. Remember, the first reported cases only came in on December 27th. Our scientists, in about 2 weeks, obtained the initial coronavirus signal, isolated the live virus, confirmed it as the COVID-19 pathogen, and shared the full-length sequences with the world. Again, China has done a great job responding to COVID-19, and we can see this as a direct result in how its economy and life in China has resulted back to normal. Now, China is certainly not out of the water yet, with the upcoming Spring Festival next month and new clusters emerging in Beijing and surrounding areas. China is not taking any chances. They're introducing a new travel QR code system. There will be increased securities at various checkpoints across the country, and China will do everything it can to continue to monitor COVID-19 and to protect its citizens as it did in 2020. Now, in conclusion, I'm going to end today's video with some comments from Martin Jacques. Martin is an outstanding scholar and one of the most outspoken voices for the country of China. Let's listen in to hear his thoughts on this situation. What is the West's response to China's remarkable handling of COVID-19? The answer is simple. Ignore it. In the beginning, the UK government included the Chinese figures at its media conferences. Then they disappeared. A bit later, South Korea vanished too. It was all too embarrassing. The strategy is either to ignore China and pretend it doesn't exist, no figure, no news, or demonize it. As a result, it is now virtually impossible to read anything serious about China or East Asia in the Western media. There is the odd sensible piece, but only in rarely. This is very dangerous, not for China. China can take care of itself as it is handling of the pandemic and its impressive economic growth demonstrate. It is dangerous for the West. China is rising. It is hugely competent. It can do things we can't. We need to learn from it. Now, this is my big message, and this is how I want to conclude this video. Let's stop blaming China for every problem that we have. It's time for everybody in your country, in the world, to unite and realize that the coronavirus is, of course, a global problem. It is not something that we can blame somebody else on. It's up to us as individuals to do our part to stop the spread and eventually move on with our life. Now, one of the positive signs that I've seen came actually from the Epoch Times. Now, the Epoch Times is one of the largest anti-China publications that you will find out there. Literally, every article they produce portrays China in a negative light. For the better part of 2020, over 8 months, they always called it the China virus. On the top of their app, it was labeled China virus. But magically, in 2021, they've now changed it to coronavirus. Even the biggest anti-China publication out there has changed its tune. It's realized we can't call it the China virus. It realized that we can't blame China for this anymore. It's time to move forward. Let's learn from the Epoch Times. Let's learn to work together. Guys, stay positive. 2021 is still going to be a positive year. Now, everybody, I want to thank you for taking time out of your day to spend it with me here on YouTube. If you are new to the channel, I want you to hit that subscribe button. And if you are interested in joining our team, come check out the links in the description below. You can come join us on Patreon for my exclusive weekly video for my Patreon subscribers. In addition to that, come and sign up for the free newsletter where I put out new publications every week. We have a lot of exciting things in the pipeline for 2021 as we help more people around the world understand China. Everyone, my name is Cyrus Jansen. Thank you for being here, and we'll see you in the next video.